Boy, if you thought Super Mario Land was weird, let me tell you. To coin a phrase, you ain't seen nothing yet. Hi, I'm Duke of the Bomb. Let's play Super Mario Land 2, 6 Golden Coins, trademark, copyright 1992 Nintendo. Released in 1992 for the Nintendo Game Boy Entertainment System. This is the follow-up to the Mario game I just finished yesterday. I hope you all enjoyed that series. Already this looks leaps and bounds better than Super Mario Land. This is in a post Super Mario World, so a lot of visual elements of this game kind of resemble SMW on a much smaller scale. The sprite looks pretty similar to Super Mario World, just in black and white and lower res. These Goombas, I don't know. They look like Goombas in another game, but I can't quite remember which one. I guess they look most resemble Super Mario Bros. 3. We have full back and forth screen scrolling. Sprites are much larger. We have a HUD, which we didn't have before. Well, I guess we had like the number of coins we had in our points, but this has an extra variable down there, which appears to be the number of enemies I've killed, which I don't know if that'll come into play, if that statistic is just there for fun, or if that means anything in the game. Like I said in the previous series, I played this very briefly in an emulator. I didn't make it that far, but I do remember there being some pretty crazy worlds. Piranha Plant looks very Mario-ish, unlike in the previous game. Just, this game looks much more like Mario in general, but there's still weird little things. For example, the 1-Up is still a heart. The star didn't move. I don't know what that bell does. Aw, man, if I had run into those things, I probably would have gotten a 1-Up. So we have a more traditional fire flower, with multiple projectiles, the same familiar animation and sound effect. For some reason, Mario has a feather on his head. I don't know if that's just... I mean, you need some sort of visual indicator, I guess, that Mario has a power-up, since there's no color, so the normal color change doesn't, you wouldn't be able to see that. I don't know why a feather... if that signifies anything. So we have these special blocks that you can destroy with fireballs. The projectiles no longer pick up coins. That was a strictly Super Mario Land 1 feature. As I demonstrated a bit ago, you have the spin jump from Super Mario World. You do that by holding down on the D-pad and pressing jump. Very smooth transition when you go in the pipes. It all seems like one seamless world. Very technically impressive for the Game Boy, I have to say. It's kind of amazing how much of a difference 1 year can make. I mean, this is like... Mario Land was like... pre-NES levels of sophistication. And this game is like full-blown Super NES. I mean, in terms of like how much stuff there is. Not necessarily visual fidelity. So we have a different mini game here, kind of a claw game. Reminds me of the claw game in Kirby. Kirby's Adventure had a similar game. Wow, that was way off. But I do get to see what this carrot power-up does. I don't actually remember what that does. Well, it gave me bunny ears, I guess? Or are those like wings from my hat? So, the Overworld, it has sort of a Super Mario 3 or Super Mario World style map. I guess it's more like Super Mario World since everything seems to be connected. This appears to be the final goal, and from the 6 indentations there, I assume those are the 6 golden coins referred to in the title of the game, and I have I have a bunch of coins, but I don't have big coins like that. Special coins, and there's the very first appearance of Wario running back and forth on top of that very imposing looking castle. So, I guess we'll have to come back to you later. So, the overworld is divided up into zones, and I'll show you what one of the zones looks like here. This is tree zone, and it looks like there are two or maybe three levels. I don't know if the one on the left is actually a level or not, because there's no, like, dot there. Well, I mean, there's only a dot on the top. So I'm assuming that each of those nodes is a separate level in the zone, so three or maybe four? I don't know, it's hard to tell. Well, it won't let me advance past the space I was standing on, so I'm assuming that if I hit A on the screen, that'll take me to the first level of tree zone. But I don't want to do that just yet. There are a few levels just in the overworld separate from anything else, and I guess for this first video, that's what I'm going to go ahead and do. If you step onto that space, you get sucked into turtle zone, but you can leave. Looks more like whale submarine fish zone. There's a lot going on inside that turtle. I look forward to seeing what the deal is. So before we go, I guess each video from this point on is going to be one of the zones, but for now, I'll do these weird standalone levels that are on the overworld screen. Okay, well, that's a power-up I very quickly lost. But it gave me some sort of floaty ability, kind of like the, seemed like the tail from Super Mario 3, where you have to pump the button to float, as opposed to hold it. That was a fire flower that I missed, so, you know, I'm just doing gangbusters here so far. Not much to this level. Just Goombas and power-up boxes. There we go. So one of the differences between the Mario Land games and every other Mario game, I don't think I pointed this out in the last LP, but when you get a power-up or get hit, there's not the momentary pause that you get. Like, in every other Mario game, I think literally every other Mario game, when you get a power-up, there's just a brief little, hitch when you get a power-up or get hit. And let me tell you, in the multiplayer Mario games, like the new Super Mario Bros. Games, that's like the number one cause of frustration and madness and hate and fear and anguish, is that little hitch whenever someone gets a power-up or gets hit just screws everyone else up completely. So I kind of wish they went with the Super Mario Land style of power-up collection, where it's just smooth and there's no hitch. I mean, it doesn't feel quite as impressive, I guess, but it would work better in a multiplayer context, I think. So this is the Hippo Zone, I guess? I did check this level out briefly. So that thing spits out a bubble that you can control by holding the jump button. I thought it was pumping the jump button at first, but that is not how it operates. This is an air-only bubble. It does not operate underwater. However, I do want to check out what's underwater, because there's some stuff down here. Very generous time limit in this game. Those are a little faster than normal seconds, than our normal human seconds, but I imagine it equates to about 10 minutes or so. Okay, so that gave me 50 coins, and you'll notice on the coin counter, I did not get an extra life at 100, and it did not roll back to 0, which is very curious. This might be the only Mario game I've ever played where that's the case. So we needed a fireball to get in here, but we can't go through unless we're small. So I'm going to get hit just to see, because obviously they designed that for a reason. I mean, they wouldn't put that there unless there was something good in here, right? Well, okay. 2 1-ups. I'll probably get another fire flower pretty soon, so I'd say that was worth it in the end. But now we're stuck down here. Well, we're not stuck. We could go all the way back and jump back out. See if there's anything else worth getting down here before I do that, though. Ah, there's a Cheep Cheep we know and love. It appears to be very panicky about something. See, no pause, no hitch. You just collect it and go about your merry way. Which, I don't know, I kind of like that. I think more Mario games should use that style of power-up collection. Very bright, cheerful music. I'm not liking it quite as much as the music in Super Mario Land so far. So it's a little busy. I mean, it's good. I like it. There's kind of a lot going on for the Game Boy. Oh, by the way, I think I figured out what was causing those weird audio distortion fields in the last LP. So hopefully we won't have any more of those. Kind of wish I didn't die there. I wonder if those 1-ups come back. If you can just, farm this level for 1-ups. That'd be a pretty tedious way to do it. Since for every time you die and come back, there would only be, you would only get one extra life out of it for your troubles. Alright, let's take the high road this time and see if I fare better. Underwater level, also something that did not appear in the previous game. So, in manga and anime, like a bubble coming out of something's nose like that usually means it's asleep. That's like a snoring bubble or something. But in this case, I don't know, his eyes are open, so it might just be a normal snot bubble. We might be taking a hippo snot ride. And if you think that sounds like fun, then you have a lot to look forward to in this LP. Because there is a lot of weird stuff like that. I wonder if this is the same team that went on to make the WarioWare games. Because those games are really weird too. I really love WarioWare on the Game Boy. It's not the kind of game that would make an entertaining LP. So I doubt I'll ever do that. I might do it in a live stream or something, just for kicks. But yeah, that game was awesome. I never played any of the other WarioWare games. That's not true. I played WarioWare. Oh man, not Twisted. What was the one on the DS? I forget. There's Smooth Moves. That was the Wii one, I think. Or was that the DS one? Might have been Smooth Moves. Alright, I can't figure out how to get up there into that goal zone. There's no, doesn't appear to be anything to jump off of. I was thinking one of those birds, maybe, but I don't know how to get them flying in the correct direction. The momentum on the jump seems a little weird. Like, every now and then I'll go and try for a running jump to get more height, but like, I won't be running for the correct length of time, and my jump will fall short. So yeah, gonna have to get used to it. Okay, so going through that hippo took us to a different part of the map. There's the hippo up there in the top left. See, I don't know what that accomplishes. I mean, you can keep going back to that level, but I can just get here without using the hippo. So I don't know what the point of that was. Very curious. We have almost 300 coins, which is bonkers for a Mario game. And we cannot go back to the first level, but we can go back to the other two levels I played if I want to for some reason. Alright, just a couple more things to show off here. We have, this is why you can collect more than 100 coins. It looks like you can have up to 1,000. You spend your coins in this little mini game, and the more coins you spend, obviously the higher chance you have of getting something awesome. It's very difficult to predict what you're going to get in this game. You just kind of have to hit it and hope. Oh, okay. I got 3 extra lives for spending 200 coins. So in the long run, that was a better live to coin value than you would get in any other Mario game. Up here, oh right, that's just the castle. There's one more thing. Yeah, I know. You know, it was nice of Wario to inscribe Mario Land 2 on the door to his castle. That makes it very obvious that that's where I need to go. Alright, okay, that's the Turtle Zone. I thought there was one more thing in the Overworld. Maybe not. I mean, there might be other things on the Overworld later on that I'm missing. Oh yeah. Boy, I can't wait to find out what the hell this is. It's the Mario Zone. What? I don't even know. I look forward to discovering that with you. Let's see, we have the Pumpkin Zone. Okay, I'll just give you a little tour of what the zones are. We have Tree Zone, Mario Zone, Pumpkin Zone. Over here is Macro Zone, which looks to be similar to Giant World from Super Mario Bros. 3, which I'm very excited about. That was one of my favorite levels in that game. And I guess that's it. We have this hippo up here, nothing else to mention. Not really thinking of any specific order I want to tackle these levels in. And we have the minigame zone. And I mean, I don't know if there's any other reason to hang on to your coins, or if you can just go ahead and spend them all here without repercussion. Well, that was actually helpful. I don't know if there's like other shops or anything later on. This is almost entirely new to me. So, I guess that'll do it for this episode then. Welcome to Super Mario Land 2. Things are only going to get weirder. Tune in tomorrow while I tackle one of the zones. Haven't decided which one yet. Probably Tree Zone, just because that's the closest. And, you know, it's the most boring. I want to say the more interesting ones for later. So, yeah, should be fun. See you all then. Goodbye.